This is the Thriving Dentist Show with Gary Takas, where we help you develop your ideal dental practice, one that provides personal, professional, and financial satisfaction. Here's your host, Andy Traub.
Welcome back to another episode of the Thriving Dentist Show. I'm your host, Andy Traub, joined as always by my friend, Mr. Gary Takas. What's up, Gary?
Hey, Andy, great to hear your voice. This is going to be a fun show. I won't disclose who our guest is just yet, but he's a good friend and just someone that, if it's possible, is as passionate about dentistry as I am. Can you imagine that?
How about a close second? Let's not get over. I don't know.
He might be able to carry that passion torch just
all
as
right.
well as I do.
All right. Well, we can pass the baton later. So, you know, Gary, I know that one of your favorite quotes, and it's actually one of mine, and it's similar to this, which is, if you want to be successful, then do what successful people do. I like the one that says, if you want to be rich, then do rich people stuff. So, you know, we're not exactly sure. Mine's a Dave Ramsey quote. I'm not exactly sure who yours was, but same principle. And so we know that it makes sense. If you want to be successful, then do what successful people do. So today we're very fortunate to have a very special guest on the Thriving Dentist Show, and that's Dr. Mark Hyman. He has been practicing cosmetic and family dentistry in Greensboro, North Carolina for over 26 years. Dr. Hyman has a very successful practice measured by about any metric that we could use. So perhaps most importantly, Dr. Hyman's passion for dentistry, it's evident in everything he does. And he's had the privilege of sharing his message at virtually every dental meeting in North America. So if you ever never had the opportunity to hear Dr. Hyman speak, you're in for a treat because you get to hear him talk today. We're very excited to have you join us today, Dr. Hyman, on our show as you share some tips on helping our listeners develop thriving practices. So Dr. Hyman, thanks for joining us today.
Andy, Gary, I'm thrilled to be here and just honored to meet the legend, Gary.
Hey, Mark, thanks for joining us. I know your time is precious, and I'm so excited to have you on the show. You know, we're going to have a great time.
Yeah, Gary, and before we jump into the show, I do know we want to hear a whitening revolution segment from our friends at Phillips. So, you know, whitening's a huge part of your practice. We've talked about it so many times on the Thriving Dentist Show throughout our 80-some episodes. So what's some whitening revolution ideas you can share, some real practical information with our listeners?
I've got a great tip for our listeners today. And let me go back and recap very quickly. This is our fourth whitening revolution segment. In the first one, I suggested that we take a shade match of your patients at the beginning of the hygiene appointment so they can visually see their shade compared to what it could be. The second whitening revolution tip was to set an aggressive goal, a goal of doing one whitening procedure a day. While that's an aggressive goal, it's entirely possible. And the third whitening revolution tip was to assign someone on your team as the whitening champion, someone to be your whitening quarterback to carry this project so it remains top of mind in your practice. That's the quick review. Now let me get into today's tip. My tip today, as part of whitening revolution, is I want to encourage you to develop a seasonal promotional calendar in your practice, a seasonal promotional calendar to promote whitening at different times throughout the year in your practice. And I want to present a resource that'll help you do that. Phillips has developed an amazing website. It's PhillipsOralHealthcare.com, PhillipsOralHealthcare.com. I want you to go on that site, and I want you to click on Marketing and Practice Building tab. You'll notice a Marketing and Practice Building tab. And in that tab, within that tab, you're going to see some great resource material that you can use to print in your practice to help you develop this idea of a seasonal promotional calendar. Phillips has provided some great material that you can download. It's in digital format, in PDF format, that you can print those. For example, it might be something like promoting whitening during the wedding season, during the May-June season. There's some material that you can use to print that you can display on your countertop display that can help make whitening a seasonal year-round promotion in your practice. So that's my whitening revolution tip of the show. Develop a seasonal promotional calendar so that you can keep whitening top of mind for your patients throughout the year.
Awesome. Good stuff. Well, go ahead and jump into it with Dr. Hyman. And Dr. Hyman, again, thanks for joining us. Looking forward to hearing more about how you can help others, since you've figured it out, how to build a thriving practice.
Well, hey, let me provide a short introduction before we get into our interview. And Mark, there are many of our listeners will need no introduction for you. You're very well known in our profession. You're a real thought leader, an influencer in the dental profession. I think maybe what's most important is that you are a practicing dentist. You're a wet gloved dentist where you practice every day in your practice in Greensboro, North Carolina. However, you also had the privilege of lecturing at almost every dental meeting throughout North America, and you're one of the most entertaining, energetic, and enthusiastic lecturers on the planet. Mark, how's that for an abbreviated introduction? I could actually go out and read your credentials, and your credentials are as long as my arm, and it would probably take the entire show to read all your credentials, but how's that for an abbreviated introduction?
Gary, that's plenty. I'm blushing here over the air.
All right. Well, if this is one time where we need video, because we could see you blush in person if we had this in video. But hey, anyway, Mark, we're going to make this show a bit of a smorgasbord, and we're going to talk about a lot of different topics. You know, you give a great course titled The 360-Degree Slam Dunk Guide to a Successful Practice, and we've slightly adapted that to the title of this show being A 360-Degree Slam Dunk Guide to a Thriving Practice. I assume that basketball reference would have something to do with you being from North Carolina. Would that be correct?
I am a Tar Heel. I'm very proud of it. But I would say to anybody, the most exciting plays in basketball is when the player spins around, does a 360 turnaround, and slams the ball home. In the same vein, our listeners can do a 360-degree evaluation of their practice where they look at all aspects of their practice. And I think when they find, by paying attention to these details, that they can raise their game, little tiny bits of pieces of inefficiency that they can improve on can make massive differences. And I'm very humbled to have the privilege of the podium like you, Gary. You know, for me, I'm not in Palm Beach or Beverly Hills or Manhattan. I'm in Greensboro, North Carolina. Our three biggest employers are furniture, textiles, and tobacco. So in the face of the god-awful economy, we're still thriving and booming because we pay attention to these principles, and we're constantly doing a 360 evaluation of our practice and seeing how we can raise ourselves just a little bit every day.
That gives our listeners a nice context for some of the ways that they can kind of process the information that we're going to share with them today in our interview. You know, Mark, you may know that we recently interviewed a friend of yours and mine, Dr. John Flukey, on our show. And we interviewed him on technology and dentistry. And I know that you share a similar passion with John for and myself and Andy for technology. And so if I had to put you on the spot, Mark, what are some, in your opinion, what are some technology must-haves for dentists today?
Right. Gary, I think, again, the reason I've been successful in the seminar world is I don't say, here's what you should do. I say, here's what I did. For me, 8 o'clock this morning, Beth walked into practice. Holiday weekend, she's broken a tooth. So what do you do? Bang, it's 8 o'clock. The first thing we do is we get our digital doc intraoral camera out and take a picture of the broken tooth. Gary, Andy, we've got 8 operatories. We have 8 intraoral cameras. We take a picture on every patient before, during, and after. I would say to anybody, it's the singular most important thing that we do because we are a visual society. And the beauty of that is you put the broken body part up in front of the patient and you just shut up. Or you look at him and you say that amazing closing word, wow, and just stop. And the patient inevitably points to the screen and says, my tooth is cracked. You need to fix it. Then what I'll say to my audience is that the next thing you say, let's get a pre-denial from the insurance company, I'm going to shoot you. You know, it's nuts to not move forward. The first thing then we'll do after they see they've got a broken body part, we'll talk about how do we get comfortable financing for them, whether they want to, they don't have the prepay option, but we will give them a bookkeeping courtesy if they pay on the spot or they use their charge card. Or we partner with Care Credit. Last year we put just under $400,000 on Care Credit. So basically, we offer it to everybody, saying we can use our financial partner, or I'll pay your interest to 6 to 12 months. That makes sense? Bang. If they do, then we use, the first thing we do then after we've got the comfortable financing, they own their problems, is we give them the gentlest injection they ever had, and we use Onset, the buffering agent from On Pharma. Have you heard of that, Gary?
I have. You bet.
Gary, that's been a transformational thing for our practice. We've been buffering our local on every patient since August 2011. In the face of this awful economy, I am generating my all-time high per-day production, and it's the one thing my team and I can figure out that's different. from the day before we started buffering every shot to now we buffer. For those who aren't aware of that, basically when you use your lidocaine, you're injecting lemon juice. It's an acid. It's the pH, the acidity is 3.5. You buffer with Onset, it changes the lemon juice into water. Instead of the, you know, your mandibular block taking 10 to 15 minutes to hit, they're numb in 2 minutes and you're dancing. So they see the picture, you got the comfortable financing, you numb them with the gentlest injection, the quickest injection they've ever had. Then we pop in an isolite, the bite block, the combination bite block, tongue retractor, cheek retractor, suction, fiber optic light, the 5-in-1. If your listeners aren't using with isolite now, they're killing themselves. So basically, with the Onset, you save about 10 minutes of every visit. With the isolite, you save 30 to 50% of the time it takes you to do a procedure. Then we're big CAD-CAM CERAC users. I've used CERAC since 1998. So Beth comes in with a broken body part. She sees the problem. We get the money out of the way. Comfortable injection, put in the isolite, do the prep. We scan her with the CERAC. It's milled in 6 to 8 minutes. And then when we cure, Gary, this kills me in dentistry. I ask my audience, how many curing lights do you use? And people say, one. Why? Oh, well, that's the way we learned in dental school. So we use Flashlight, which is a DenMat product, a former Discus product. I think they cost about $500. We've got 2 curing lights at every operatory because I would say to anybody, all we have is our time, our CEO, doctor-only time. So if I can cut the time it takes you to get the patient numb, to get the tooth isolated, to mill the restoration 6 to 8 minutes instead of 3 weeks to get it back from your lab, you cure it with 2 curing lights. I can basically save every doc and every teammate listening to this today, I can save you an hour a day. So in the context of that, in that extra hour, if I can only get you to add one filling at $100 times 200 days, that's a $20,000 raise right there. If I can get you to add one extra crown, that's roughly a $200,000 increase in the next 12 months just by working smarter. So it's spending small dollars and innovating for a massive result. So that's what we did for Beth. She walked in at 8 o'clock. At about 5 after 9, she walked out with her new tooth. And you put the bow on the package. You take the before, the during. You take the after photo. You print that out. And that becomes your business card. She goes to work and says, you won't believe what my doc did. I broke a tooth over the holiday weekend, and he fixed it before I knew what happened. And I don't have to go back. And I didn't gag on the impression. So I think Brother John Flukey is a wonderful thought leader, and I have a lot of respect for him, and I hope he spoke about some of these issues. But that's what you can do in the real world. It takes training, it takes planning, but you invest in these technologies. There's not a practice listening that can't add $100,000 in the next 12 months just working a little smarter.
And that difference, Mark, let's use that number on the low side, $100,000, and perhaps with a little bit more efficiency, that number could be $200,000 on an annual basis. Imagine the difference that it makes to that practice in terms of their overhead, in terms of their profitability by adding another $100,000 to $200,000 a year in revenue with very minor increases in overhead associated with that revenue. There will be some minor increases in overhead associated with that, but very minor, and the majority of that goes right to the bottom line in the form of increased profitability, which I know you know, Mark, but I wanted to emphasize that for our listeners as well.
Right, the multiplier of that, to me, there's nothing wrong with being richly rewarded for delivering excellence. Sometimes I think we in dentistry, we're embarrassed to talk about money and embarrassed to talk about success, but with that level of success means you can take exquisite care of your teammates. You can take great care of securing your family. You can give very generously to your church and synagogue and your United Way and your dental school. And you can provide charity dentistry for those who truly need it without any concern that you can't make your payments. I think one of the most divisive thing we have in dentistry is the battle over debt from young dental students and then treating your patients based on your need for financial gain instead of from abundance.
You're right.
That's a tough thing to talk about, but I think the liberating thing for me to be at this stage in my career is I can choose who I treat. I can take on a big case a just because case, as Kathy Jamison would call it, just because dentistry, because you are successful and because you give back because you choose to.
You know, I've often said in my lectures that you can't give from an empty wagon, and it's important to have that abundance and financial success so that we can give some of it away. And, you know, Mark, I was taking notes here, and I'm going to encourage our listeners, not if you're driving, of course, if you're driving, just sit back and listen to it and replay this once you get home. But I just heard five specific pieces of technology that you would consider a must-have. Hey, Mark, check my listening skills and see if I got these right. In order, you talked about the importance of photography for patient education. Secondly, you talked about the importance of having some financial tools so people can afford to have the dentistry. Third, you talked about painless anesthesia that accelerates the anesthetic process. Fourth, you talked about Isolite so that we can work much more efficiently. And fifth, you talked about CAD-CAM or CEREC dentistry. Did I get those five?
You did, and I would add multiple curing lights to submit your CAD-CAM restoration.
Thank you. We have six. So there you go. We have six. You know, interestingly enough, Mark, one of our mentors, yours and mine, Dr. Omer Reed, who we had the privilege of having on the show, at 84 years young, by the way, and I did say that correctly, Dr. Reed would consider himself 84 years young. And when I first met Omer in 1982, he talked about his desire to brand his practice in the mind and eyes of his patients. And Mark, in 1982, Omer wanted to be known as the painless on-time dentist. Does that make any sense?
You think about that, to do that, there's no competition because no one else is doing it.
No one else was doing it then, and too few are doing it today, even, you know, many years later, too few are even doing it today. But I found that interesting because as you're talking about anesthesia and painless anesthetic, it was something that, you know, people absolutely want. And so you're giving them something that they want. Well, I mentioned the show is going to be a bit of a smorgasbord. We're going to bounce around and talk about a lot of fun things. So I wanted to start with technology. Next, I want to talk about the idea of a dream team. We know what that meant in basketball. Mark, the dream team. But let's talk about in dentistry. How can dentists create a happy and rewarded team?
You know, what's amazing to me is basically dentists are scientists and engineers, and we're not leaders by nature, but we can all learn and we can improve. And I made so many mistakes my first 90 days in private practice. I got mad at myself and then had the privilege of hearing Linda Miles speak in the fall of 1986, and it changed my life.
By the way, we had Linda on our show, and it is one of the most downloaded episodes in the history of the Thriving Dentist Show. And, you know, Mark, so you know this, our show, I'm quite humbled to realize this, but it's been downloaded by dentists in 102 countries.
Awesome.
And there were many dentists that around the world that had never had the privilege of hearing Linda, and of course here in the United States she's just an icon, and everybody in dentistry has heard of her. But it was so wonderful to share her message with dentists in 102 countries that maybe had the opportunity to hear her for the first time.
She's amazing, and Linda continues to inspire me today. And then I met Kathy and John Jamison at a discus meeting, actually, discus dental meeting about 13 years ago, sat next to them at the Cirque du Soleil show, and ended up working with Kathy and her folks, and they're just amazing. Kathy said 8 words to me 13 years ago that changed my life, which was, how do you create the sense of urgency? How do you create the sense of urgency so your patients see you have something important to say and there's a reason to act? And that feeds into everything that we talked about before. So back to your dream team concept, to me, I realized where I didn't have skills, and I started going to meetings, reading books, listening to audio tapes. I invited myself to lunch with pretty much every general dentist in Greensboro and would ask them the same question: Gary, how do you hire? How do you fire? How do you set fees? What do you do this? And I kind of got an MBA on the spot like that. So when I think about my dream team, the striking thing for me is every woman that I work for, there's 10 women on staff now, every woman on the team that I work for used to work for another dentist, and now I have them. And that's just kind of mind-boggling to me because they are so good and so smart and so funny. And someone else had them and blew it because they didn't keep them. They didn't spoil them. So things that I kind of think about, factors of our dream team, you know, the number one, two, and three thing I hear when I do my seminars is the biggest issue folks have is the issue of communication and how do engineers and scientists communicate well. It's cliche as all get out. We do our morning huddle, morning meeting. It is brutally efficient. 20 till 8, we meet. And it's not the murder report, Mrs. Smith is coming at 8 for cleaning, Mrs. Jones at 9. We can all read. The hygienists say at 8, Mrs. Jones has a watch on 3031, the 9 o'clock restorative patient just canceled. Can we get her to stay? Mrs. Smith at 9 o'clock wanted whitening, broke a tooth, went to endo, went to crown lengthening. We've never whitened her teeth. Who can get the impression? So like that. Then once a month I take each department out. I go out with the assistants for lunch, then the hygienist, then the assistants. The hygienist, the assistants, and the business team, three separate lunches. Then we have our staff meeting for 2 hours every month. Twice a year we have a half-day off-site meeting. We bring in Jameson Management 6 days a year. And we go on one or two dream trips a year as well. Last year we went to the Hyman in Atlanta and the ADA in San Francisco. So that's been pretty wild. Further for us, we're a reading learning organization. As a team, we read books together. So as a team, we've read Seven Habits of Highly Effective People by Stephen Covey, ZAP, Z-A-P-P, The Lightning of Empowerment by Bynum and Cox. We've read Who Moved My Cheese, Millionaire Next Door. We read Collins, Good to Great, with the idea of getting the right people on the bus and then the right people in the right seat. That was transformational for us. And a buddy of mine, Rich Schlentz, just had a book come out, which the team adores. And I think it's an Amazon download for $10. And it's called Your Employees Have Quit, They Just Haven't Left.
Love that. Hey, may I recommend one for your library to include in a future book club in your office?
What's that?
It's written by a very good friend of mine, Dr. James Gulnick. James is a dentist in London. James has been on our show a couple times. He's the past president of the BACD, the British Academy of Cosmetic Dentistry, and he wrote a very simple book titled Brush. Brush. And it's a blueprint for developing a successful practice and life. And Mark, you will love it. You will absolutely treasure this book. You and James are cut from the same cloth. And it is indeed. However,
I would love to read that. I'll suggest that to the team. Anyway, so my buddy Rich Schlentz came up with this book, 9 Fundamental Principles to Engage and Transform Your Workplace Culture. And just the cost to dental offices in inefficiency, absenteeism, bad attitude, backbiting. Again, if I can save one team from firing one teammate or one person quitting a year, it's been estimated in dentistry that you lose an entire year's salary when you lose an employee, a teammate, an inefficiency, training costs, new uniforms. So I've been practicing almost 28 years now. You think if I'd lost one teammate a year, over 28 years, it's just devastating. So we communicate well. We work on the teamwork. We educate ourselves. We do a lot of lunch and learns. Everybody in the practice has gone through Dale Carnegie, How to Win Friends and Influence People.
Yes.
Amazing, amazing training. For me personally, I started going to the Pankey Institute in 1990, and that was transformational for my life. And I'm now a mentor at the Scottsdale Center. And just appreciate that privilege. So again, I feel like the entire team, part of the obligation is to constantly improve and learn and to help each other out. So I think that's how the dream team is formed. One of my favorite expressions in reference to leadership, if you're leading and no one is following, you're just taking a walk.
Boy, I love that.
All of us in dentistry need to lead better and lead with purpose and inspire the team, and it takes time and it takes risk. We had a staff meeting last Thursday with plenty of tears and some ill will, and that's the risk you take when you go out on the edge for excellence. So that's I'm very proud of my dream team, the women I work for now. They've been with me total over 100 years. My head administrator's been with me 23 years, my head assistant 15, head hygienist 12. I'm very proud of that.
Well, you should be, Mark. You know, those are wonderful accomplishments, and you and I have such a similar philosophy when it comes to developing a dream team. And, you know, I think one of the ways you characterized it is maybe just a perspective that's needed by all of us, or a reminder. I noticed you said multiple times, it's the people you work for, you work for.
Yeah. And it's a different perspective. The way many of us were trained in dentistry were from the Imperial Dental Faculty, who were ex-military, and it was very humiliating and intimidating and authoritarian, and that just doesn't work in a relationship-based, high-touch practice like we have.
Yeah, so, right. You might remember in the book Good to Great, in Jim Collins' book, he talks about the different levels of leadership, and he characterizes the level 5 leader as being the profound, the most profound way to lead effectively. And you might remember what level 4 was. Mark, I won't ask you, because we didn't talk about it in the preparation, but a level 4 leader was a genius with 1,000 helpers. A genius, so a level 4 leader, which is a very effective leader, it's a genius with 1,000 helpers. And I kind of think that describes the way a lot of dentists perform their own leadership in their own practice. And I'd suggest that there's a better way, and that's that level 5.
I love that, and I'm amazed in my seminars when I'll ask how many people own CERAC, and still market penetration's too low. I think it's 7 or 10% of the dentists. And I'll ask how many of you let the team do the designing, and almost no hands go up. And I'm just saying, you're nuts. Why are you sitting there playing with an Etch-a-Sketch? Let the team do it. They're young. They're computer savvy. And if you let them drive a $100,000 piece of machinery every day, do you think they're going to go somewhere else?
So you're absolutely right. You're absolutely right.
It's just, and I'd rather the doctors prep and roll and go in another room and do prep another CERAC. I mean, if I can free you for these little chunks of 2 to 5 to 10 minutes of inefficiency in an 8-hour schedule, I know I can find everybody an extra hour. And that can make all the difference in a career.
Oh, massive, massive difference. Well, in the spirit of the smorgasbord approach to our topics today, let me switch gears and go to another topic that you and I both have passion for. And that's that, Mark, I know you take pride in keeping your patients informed and educated about new products and services that are available in dentistry. Can you hit some highlights on some things that you're excited about today that patients are interested in these days?
You know, if you said to me, real world private practice Monday morning, what's the number one requested procedure in your practice? It is.
I know this one. Go ahead.
Yeah, it's tooth whitening still. And as the economy got tough, what we found is less people were whitening. So we took the abundance approach instead of scarcity for someone new off the street. For us, for the trays in office whitening, using day white, night white, whatever they were using, Zoom products, the investment was $342. For our patients of record, we said, you know, you've been loyal to us all these years. If you want to whiten your teeth, it's $99. And the floodgates opened. We did so much whitening, which led to so much other cosmetic dentistry. That was just amazing for us. So we're big believers in whitening. We basically offer it to everybody. It's our second question on our health history. Patients ask us, what's the best type? I say, you know, there's good, better, best. What's your temperament? What's your time? How soon you want to be white? We did a whole lot of Zooming, and then we found that dropped down dramatically. And there's a new Zoom lamp out, which has been sensational. The sensitivity virtually has disappeared. And again, it's a totally team-run part of the practice. I have nothing to do with it. It's almost all profit. I think secondly as well is periodontal health. When you and I started in dentistry, Gary, you know, we'd say floss or die. There was no science behind it, but now there really is. So the link of gum disease and heart disease, gum disease and premature babies, low birth weight babies, Alzheimer's, diabetes, everything. We suggest power toothbrushes to everybody in the practice. I'll ask my hygienist in the audience, can your patients clean as well with a handheld manual toothbrush as they can a power toothbrush? They uniformly say no. So the research is clear, the literature is clear, so why doesn't everyone in your practice have a power toothbrush? There are many wonderful products on the market. We're huge Sonicare fans. I think the Diamond Clean's just got the sexiest thing in dentistry. That'll charge off your laptop. It'll charge off.
I have a brand new one, Mark. My Diamond Clean is about a week in my possession. I've had it about a week, and it is the coolest thing. I mean, I absolutely love it. I love the USB port for charging, for traveling, and it is fabulous.
It's amazing. We've checked out their FC Platinum version as well. It's a more comfortable price point for some practices, mm-hmm. and quality is exceptional. For us in our practice, so basically anyone with ortho gets a power toothbrush. Any senior gets a power toothbrush. Anybody that's on medication that dries your mouth, mood medications, cardiac medications. I mean, you can't really tell me a reason why somebody wouldn't benefit from it. And what we do is we find out what Costco, Walmart, Sam's Club are selling these for, and we sell them for cheaper than that. I'm not trying to make money on a power toothbrush. I'm not hawking toothbrushes. But the benefit of this is huge. I've had some people say in my seminars, Gary and Andy, that, well, I don't want to retail. And so I'll say, fine, add $100 to your scaling root planing. Give him the dang brush.
That's right. That's right. Hey, Mark, come back clinically for a minute. Come back to the new lamp with Zoom, the new Whitespeed lamp. And I know about it, through my experience with Philips, but I'd like you to explain a little bit to the to our listeners what's new and improved about the lamp. Could you touch on that briefly?
You know, one thing I'm real good about is knowing what my limitations are. And I think they changed the bulb. And I don't know that they changed the wavelength, so someone else could speak more intelligently mm-hmm. to that. I know our sensitivity has dropped out the bottom. So where we had some people complaining, they loved that they got 6 to 8 shade changes, but they had some transient sensitivity. And now, doing the Whitespeed lamp, we really haven't had anybody complain, and the results are sensational.
The new bulb, Mark, is and Ellie Phillips, is the owner of the brand, and Phillips is perhaps best known. They're an international company based in the Netherlands, and perhaps they're best known for their light bulb technology. So it won't come as a surprise to our listeners to know that one of the changes that they made to the lamp had to do with the bulb. And the new bulb is an LED technology. It has a 50,000-hour life, by the way, in that bulb. 50,000 hours. I don't think we'll be replacing bulbs anytime soon. Do you, Mark? Even with the amount of whitening that we do, I don't think we'll be replacing that bulb anytime soon with a 50,000-hour lifespan.
I don't think so, and if you did, what a privilege.
I would love to. I'd love to be the first one to wear one out. But it also has, Mark, on the light head, on the head of the lamp, it's got three settings, essentially a high, medium, low setting, so you can literally change the setting for the patient based on their history of sensitivity. And so, you could start it out at a medium setting, and if the patient was not experiencing any sensitivity, you could dial it back up to a high setting. Likewise, you could dial it back low. So it really gives you the opportunity to modulate the intensity of the light to personalize the experience for the patient.
I think it's been fantastic. It's it shows me that if Philips bought this product and improved upon it, which makes it that much more valuable. So to me, anyone that says Zoom doesn't work or you get sensitivity, they just haven't tried the LED version. And I think the longer you let it sit there and don't use it, you miss a colossal opportunity to lead to other aspects of cosmetic and reconstructive dentistry, because the whitening just becomes the hors d'oeuvre.
I talk about it as a gateway service, and I know you're thinking you didn't use that term, but in my courses I talk about whitening as a gateway service. So I love your pricing strategy as well, Mark, because I don't necessarily agree in giving it away, although we certainly do give it away in certain applications. For example, if we're doing an upper anterior porcelain veneer case, we'll throw in Zoom on the lower arch as part of that case, by all means. But I like the idea of charging something for it, because I find that when we charge something for it. The patient has more commitment, more investment in it. But I love the way you value priced it. And I think I heard correctly, you indicated for your wonderful existing patients, you offer it at $99. Is that correct?
In a long-term commitment to me during these tough financial times, may I give you a gift? May I say,
love it.
If you just pay my cost on this, it's yours. Happy birthday, happy wedding, whatever it is. You know, one of the neatest things we've done for the whitening is when someone says you're engaged, Gary, what's the first thing you think about? I know Andy would say don't do it, right?
Well, I was waiting for Andy to chime in, but since you went ahead.
Beat you to it.
So, you beat him to it.
Congratulations, when's the wedding? And then I want our listeners to paint that verbal word picture. When you walk down the aisle, what do you want your smile to look like? When your dad's walking you down the aisle, what would you like your smile to look like? When you're taking your engagement photos, is there anything about your smile you want to change? And everybody wants a wider smile. So I'll say, well, guess what? He might give you an engagement gift. We do two-for-one whitening for the bride and the groom, the mother of the bride and the bride, the entire wedding party. Anybody you bring in for the wedding, the whitening's half off. And people go nuts over it. And again, it leads to so much more. So that I think that's an opportunity to say, again, you're engaged. You tell me what you want your smile to look like when you're looking at that picture the next 50 years.
And love it.
It can lead to a ton of dentistry.
We didn't talk about this ahead of time, but I want to ask you this related to whitening. I think one of the issues that many offices are facing today, it's a psychological issue, but it's the issue of kind of been there, done that. Yeah, we've done whitening. Next, what else do you have? You know, and the problem with that thinking is that they really haven't been there, done that. And let me prove that to you, and I'll ask your input on this. There was a recent survey published in USA Today. And the survey had the following question. If there was something you could do to improve your smile, what would you do? And Mark, you won't be surprised when I tell you that 85% of the respondents said they wanted whiter teeth. This is today. This is not in 1995 or 2005, but this is today. They wanted whiter teeth today. So how can you help the listeners understand that whitening is pertinent today because that's what people want today? It has. So if they've kind of, well, we've done whitening, yeah, what else can we do? I think the idea of getting your arms around and embracing it, and you know, the goal that I like to set is a goal of doing one whitening procedure a day. Any office can do that. Any office can do that. Whether it be Zoom, chairside, or take home, we can do one whitening procedure a day. And that by no means is a limitation or a cap. That's a starting point. And I think every office can do this. And the difference, it can be a massive difference in the practice by increasing your volume from one a month, which is the average, to one a day. What are your thoughts on that?
I agree completely. I think you just can't tell me that somebody this week in your practice isn't getting their braces off. You can't tell me someone isn't getting engaged. Somebody hadn't been drinking coffee and iced tea and Coca-Cola. You know, I whitened my teeth years ago. Yeah, but look at them now. They're Vita Shade A4. So how about a touch-up? You know, I tried the trays. It took too long. But then you got the new Zoom white speed that, bang, in an hour, hour and a half, you can change their life. So I think it takes some creativity. I think it takes some future focus. You whitened. Where were you in your life then? So what's new? What's changed? Have you had any other dentistry done? And, you know, they had composites done, and they're smoking and drinking. You know that they're staining. So there's tremendous opportunity to whiten the existing teeth, to freshen up their smile. You know, I think the country as a whole is coming out of the recession, is coming out of the doldrums. Spending is improving. We're not home yet, but I see a ton of pockets of positive everywhere I go. So I think we in dentistry ought to be on the forefront of that and say it's time. It's time to treat yourself. And again, you know, you can give them a history lesson, Gary. You remember when whitening first came out? What were people charging for it? $1,000?
Oh yeah, yeah. $1,000, $1,200 was in our area in Phoenix and Scottsdale. It was $1,000 to $1,200.
So now you can say, you know, basically, if you walk in off the street, it's a cup of Starbucks. You know, a couple of Starbucks a day for couple months. That's $340. We're in our practice now. It's $99 over 365 days in a year. How much is that? It's a couple cents. You know, mm-hmm. it's a piece of gum to whiten your teeth.
So, I love that. I love that perspective. You know, Mark, to switch gears, I know that one of the things I really appreciate about you is your humanity. And you really believe in, not only believe in, but you take action in serving those people who are less fortunate. And I know it's a regular part of your practice. Can you tell us a little bit about how you incorporate community service into your practice and how you feel that that's an important part of developing a thriving practice?
Well, I think we're blessed to be Americans. We're blessed to be in this country at this time. We're blessed to be in this profession, which has given us so much. I've done some of the Mission to Mercy clinics, which are a whole nother discussion and unbelievable. For us in our practice, we probably write off about $200,000 a year. So you have to be very successful to comfortably write that off. And generally, Jewish Family Services will contact us. Lutherans Family Services will contact us. Different people like that, patients of ours will say that got someone that was down, that is down on their luck. And when someone says please, the team and I will bend over backwards. When somebody says gimme, it's harder to be excited about that. But we work really hard at being efficient and effective and profitable so that we can comfortably and lovingly give charity where we can. And we're very proud of that. And it means the team's got to support me on that. Andy, Gary, think about that. If we had full-paid patients at that time, the team could bonus more. So it takes maturity and it takes abundance instead of scarcity. But, you know, I'll never forget how fortunate we are to be in dentistry. And so I'm proud to give back.
Yeah, I'm never sure who benefits most when we get involved in projects like that. The people that receive the care or the people that provide it. You know, I think it's just such a wonderful foundation. And Mark, I want to recognize the wonderful work that you do and that your team does to give back to your community right there locally. Certainly, we can do these things on a global level, and that's fantastic. It's wonderful to do that because there are many places around the world that can benefit from you know, from your care. And as you're listening to this, I strongly encourage at some point in your career to travel internationally to a third world country to deliver that care. But let's never forget about the opportunity we have right in our own backyard. There's plenty of people in your community that could use, how does that saying go, Mark? They could use a hand up as opposed to a hand out. It's wonderful to be able to provide that that hand up and to help those that could benefit from it. And I know it's a signature of your practice. And the reason you're able to do it is that you have a successful, thriving practice. And I want to emphasize that point. Perhaps that supreme motivation is become more successful so you can do more of that. So Andy, I think you could see why I wanted to have Mark on the show. He's I was getting writer's cramp from writing down all the notes on the different topics we talked about in today's show.
Absolutely.
Did I not talk fast enough?
You did just fine. You did just fine. Well, we do thank you for sharing your information today. And if folks wanted to maybe just see some of what your practice you know, communicates publicly through their website and such, where can they maybe go to visit your site and maybe just learn a little bit more about how you run your practice?
Right, Andy, I'd be honored. Anybody is welcome to go on our website, which is tarheeldentist.com, tarheeldentist.com, which is a great domain name. People are welcome to email me with questions, smile@tarheeldentist.com. And actually, anyone that cares to can call me here at the office, 336-282-8850, and I'd be pleased to advocate for anybody any way I can. There are a lot of people, the Linda Miles, Kathy Jamesons, Naomi Rhodes, people from Panky, people from Scottsdale. I've had a rich career with people helping me, and if I can help any of the listeners in any way, I'd be honored to. So please feel free to give me a call or drop me an email. And let me know how I can help.
Awesome. I've got all those in our show notes. So this is episode number 80 of the Thriving Dentist Show. So make sure you go check out the notes either on your smartphone or at tacklesslearningcenter.com. Again, show number 80 with Dr. Hyman. So, Gary, I'll let you wrap it up.
You bet. You know, there's one homework item I want to give to our listeners, and that is that if you've never had the opportunity to hear Mark speak, you need to run, not walk, to attend one of his courses. Mark, you are one of the most entertaining speakers in our profession. And I say that with all due respect. You, I look at what you do from the podium as edutainment. Is that a fair description of what you do?
Well, I'd like to light myself on fire and watch myself burn.
You do. And I call it edutainment. I mean that as a supreme form of compliment. It's very educational that you will leave a course given by Mark with copious pages of notes. But perhaps as importantly, you'll be entertained. You'll enjoy it. You'll laugh. We'll laugh at ourselves. Mark, I remember the first time I heard you lecture, it happened to be in Vegas at one of those discus events. I was speaking in the morning and you were in the afternoon, and I made a point of staying over so I could hear your lecture. And I laughed so hard during your presentation that I had a side ache afterwards. And it was the most enjoyable dental course I'd ever attended. And I want to encourage our listeners to go out and attend a course. And you can find his lecture schedule on that website. You've got a tab there of courses, and you can find out where Mark is lecturing or email him, and he'll let you know where he's lecturing. But run, don't walk, take a course. And Mark, let me just close by saying thank you. You know, it's people like you that make our profession such a special place, and where I love spending my time and energy and my stomach and heart muscle, my stomach lining heart muscle. I love spending in our profession because of people like you. So I would just conclude by saying thank you, Mark. I appreciate all you do. Thank you.
Gary, it's been a gift to be with you, and Andy, I appreciate your professionalism, and I'd love to help again sometime.
We'll take you up on that. Thank you, Dr. Hyman, and Gary, thank you as always.
You bet.
Thanks. Better days are sure to come. And when you smile, be sure to smile wide. And don't let them know that they have won. And when you walk, walk with pride. Don't show the hurt inside, because the pain will soon be gone.